With me in the studio this afternoon, I'm joined by Angela MacPhee and Catherine Rawlin from Baker Tilly. Good afternoon. Good to see you both.
Good afternoon. Thanks for having us.
Well, let's take a step back. Tell us a bit about the detail around the merger here, Baker Tilly RGL Forensics. What was the main objective? What was the intention?
Well, we were really looking at what our next 20 years could provide. We had a great journey of the last 20 years, growing, expanding internationally. We have a phenomenal team as RGL, and we were looking at how do we continue along that path, and how do we do it at a faster pace with a larger platform. And so we actually had the opportunity to seek a process and chose Baker Tilly in the end, and we're very excited about that opportunity for us. We think it's got great business alignment for us as well as cultural alignment, because as we know, if you don't have cultural alignment, it doesn't matter how great the business alignment is, it's going to be quite the challenge. So we're excited to be on week one of the official merger.
You talk about the business alignment there. Just tell me why it's such a good fit.
Well, our forensics business is focused on the insurance, legal, and corporate space. And the largest sector for us is insurance. And Baker Tilly has an insurance practice that works with insurance companies like we do. So there's nothing that is, I would say, it's collaborative versus cannibalizing, so that's important. And then also they have very strong relationships within the legal space and the corporate space. So we'll look at that as opportunities for us to offer more to our clients and be able to take our skill sets and grow. They also are a great entrepreneurial spirit and looking to continue to grow their technology space. So we've got a digital platform that we were in the process of moving forward with. And so this just helps us, I mean, just to have those kind of resources internally is going to be phenomenal for us. So we looked at the business alignment from what we could offer our clients, what we have from our own skill sets, the new emerging areas that we had, and we found that they ticked the boxes in all of those spaces. And then on top of that, they were looking for global growth. So this gave us an opportunity to add to their strategy and growth. So they wanted to continue to grow their advisory business. So we bring in the specialty of being the premier forensic accounting side of their business. And then we also get to be on the forefront of their global expansion.
Well, I suppose before we talk about some of the more specifics of the synergies here, for those watching might be unfamiliar, say, with forensic accounting, what's involved?
Well, I'm going to turn to Catherine and let you land it to that one.
Yes, I actually am a practitioner in forensic accounting. I've been doing it now for 30 years. And essentially what it is investigations for corporates and for other businesses. We will often be called in when there might have been a fraud or a suspected fraud to investigate what has happened, or where there's some kind of litigation that's going on and the corporate needs somebody to come in and help them understand the quantum and the financial impact of that dispute.
Are we talking about what size corporates typically here?
It can be for anything, really. That's the really interesting thing. We get involved in all different sizes of business, from the really quite small, small, medium size enterprises, all the way up to multinational global companies. Anyone who has a dispute that has some kind of financial impact, they need somebody to be there and measure it, and that's where we come in.
And as Angela was saying, you were looking for those global opportunities and expansion. So really, as part of the wider group, you're set to benefit.
Yes, I mean, obviously, I was originally at RGL, as was Angela, and we were global already. And Baker Tilly in the US were looking for a global footprint, and we were there already as a global company for them to work with.
And tell us a little bit more, as far as some of your clients, your customers are concerned, what are some of the benefits here for them?
Well, we see that there are many benefits for our clients. We already provided an amazing service for our clients, so obviously we're going to say that. But but what we have with Baker Tilly is we have the addition of knowledge and skills and resources over and above those that we had within RGL. So specifically, we've got detailed sector knowledge, which we had sector knowledge also, but not at the same depth that people at Baker Tilly do in certain areas. Obviously, we're joining the Baker Tilly network, which is 147 countries, which means we can provide our clients with on-the-ground help in lots of different countries, which not only has the people there, but also it brings with it the language skills and also the cultural knowledge within the individual countries, which really helps if you're dealing with an issue for a business.
Exactly. Has the merger thrown up a few branding challenges?
It has, in one location for us. So Baker Tilly, as Catherine was just saying, operates in 147 different locations. Mm. There is one country that we've run into, and that is the UK, in which they don't own the brand. So we've had to come up with a sub-brand for this market as alone. So we'll be in the UK as BTBK Advisory.
Right.
And wholly owned by Baker Tilly. But we are Baker Tilly. We're still one global company operating together, collaborating across all of the world. But we have the one trademark issue alone in just the UK. But all of our other locations will be branded Baker Tilly.
Well, that's brilliant. Really good to see you both. Angela, Catherine, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.